This is a very simple database. It has only two tables and a few macros and a module. The auto execute macro kicks in when you open the database and it tells you Control D creates a form with a subform. The auto keys one regulates the Control D shortcut and then it runs automatically the following process. It automatically searches in one of the two tables and puts in all the boxes and saves it as subform customers. And it does the same for the main form automatically, no matter how many fields you have in that table. And I'm saving it this way. So now when I open them, I'm going to form orders. When I double click on it, this is what it looks like. So it got out of the orders form, the main form information, and then a hooked up one that does that for that company, for that customer. So when I change here, the customer, it tells me you cannot change the customer for an existing order. That would mess up your entire database. But when we go to a new record, we can automatically start whatever you want to do there. Let's say you want around the horn, and it automatically in the subform shows the information for that company, and the rest you have to fill in by hand. Okay. If you want to also the ship name and ship address taken from here, that is possible, but I won't go into that issue. So I'm just going to undo this, for I don't want to start that new order. I just want you to see how it works. I'm deleting that record and close the thing. What happens in the module? We created a module, insert a module, with a subroutine that I happen to call dynamic form. And it builds automatically those two forms, the main form and the subform. You declare a few variables, some of the object type, some of the value type. Make sure that you have the DAO library available, tools, references, and there should be a connection to the Access database engine. You can find that as an active data active object thing, or if you have a fancier version, then you look for the ACEDAO.dll. First, we are going to create a subform for the customers. As I said already, we have two simple forms, so the creation of the relationships was done here. A customer ID in the customers table has multiple customer IDs as a foreign key in the orders table, so we know to which customer that order belongs. So that's what we are doing here. So we open the record set that is called customers, that is a table. We use ORS customers, which is of the record set type. Then we create a subform that we capture in the variable O subform that opens a form in design view. We do a do command restore, otherwise that will be minimized. We move the size, and the size has four arguments: the right position, the down position, the width, and the height. The height we will do later, for we don't know yet how many fields that table has. We give it a caption. And the record source behind that subform is the name ORS customers. That is the customers record set. Then we loop for all the fields of that object type. And we run from 0 to the count minus 1. But I'm not doing 0 because that is the ID field and we don't want the ID field probably. Then if the field type of the first field, 1, 2, 3, 4, is not a database memo type, then we set the LE, the left, the top, the width and the height. We create a bunch of label boxes, create controls of the AC label type, and with this line left, top, etc. Then we give it a caption. We use the name of that field. Then we create text boxes next to the label boxes. So we do the left position plus 2100, that is eyeballing, and the width plus 1000. We use the name of that field. The control source behind that text box is that specific field's name. And then we do a few cosmetic things. And if, next I, and it does that for all the fields. Then we can by now set the top. The subform detail section has a height that is the top, the last top plus 1000. And we close that form, a subform. Then we create a main form. It's basically doing something similar again, but this time based on the table orders. We create a form again, restore it to make sure it's not minimized. We regulate the size, we give it a name, we determine the record source behind that form. We have to reset TP, for that is very high by now. Remember we did that here. Set it back to zero. For in that subform we have to start all over. We loop for all the fields. Don't forget count minus one. We check if it's not a memo one, for that needs much more space. Then we set all these values. We create controls, but this time of the label type again. The caption is of the name. If I even, we have to do something special. We have to create a combo box, a drop-down box, that allows us to choose the correct customer ID. So we make it of the combo box type. The control source behind it is, of course, the name of that field. The row source type of that combo box is a table query type. So we make a query in this case. So the row source behind it is equals, and that is an SQL statement. Select customer ID, company name from customers, order by company name. So you have them nicely alphabetical. The bound column is the first one, that means the customer ID. The column count is 2. The column width is 0 for that customer ID, 0 inches, and 1 inch for the company name. The name of that box is CBO customer ID. And then we added a macro. When someone changes that box, remember when you do that in an existing order, we want to say you cannot do that. So we are going to call the subroutine or the macro actually test. I will show you later what that looks like. If it's not the first one, then the rest is the same stuff like we did before. So I will keep that very brief. And if next. Then we place form 2 as a subform in the orders form. Dim O subcontrol as a control. Set that and we do it of the subform type with these dimensions. O form controls the one with the name of that O subcontrol. And the source object is the subform customers. We had called that earlier, so that is the source object behind that control. And then we have to link the master fields and the child fields, and they are linked through the customer ID. Then we determine the height again, because through that looping TP has increased enormously, and we do a do command close. Now we have to make a function testing. I will explain later why it has to be a function and not a sub. If the first form, they start counting at zero, if it happens to be a new record, then we go to the record previous and then next, that more or less mimics a saving option. Else, message bar. You cannot change the customer for an existing order. Okay, and we put the old value back in there because the user was trying to change the customer ID for that specific order, and that should not be possible. So that is the function testing. And then we have a function autorun, which I will explain later too, and that calls the subroutine dynamic form, and that subroutine is the one that we discussed extensively. So now we have to go back to Visual Basic. You want to know how that auto-execute one is done. So I'm going to the design view. It has only in it a message box with the message. Control D creates a form, and that's it. And when you save it, you have to save it under the name auto-execute. It will run automatically when this thing. Auto keys, a similar story, but it's a little more complicated to create it. First, you have to make sure that your action catalog is there, for you have to create a submacro first. And each submacro can have the name that stands for the shortcut key. So in this case, I did Control D. Control is the caret, the one up. D, and then we run the action run code, and run code need the name of a function, and that is that auto run function. Make sure that you end it with open close parentheses. When you save this macro, it has to be called auto keys. That means it will automatically run when you do this shortcut key or any other. Okay. And then finally we had a test one, and the test one just uses the run code action, the function, again it has to be a function, testing. Okay. And the test one was the one that kicks in the combo box in the main form if you try to change the customer ID or the customer actually from an existing order. So now we know when we open the database it will tell you Control D, so we will use Control D. It does all this work again. I'm going to say yes, because I have already a form orders and a subform customers. It will just take the first available name from now on. Form 1. It does the same for the second one, Form 2. So now when I open Form 1, I get the subform, and Form 2 will give me the main form and automatically hooked up the subform.